We live in Phoenix, Arizona. We went to our ultrasound and found out that our son had a severe heart condition. We went to a specialist where we later found out that he had a very low chance of survival till full term.
Baby Jackson was born with a condition called tetralogy of Fallot with absent pulmonary valve. The lack of that pulmonary valve creates a problem during fetal life while the baby's developing, such that the pulmonary arteries enlarge dramatically up to 5 or 10 times larger than normal. And as a result, once the baby's born, there may be some difficulty with breathing. That difficulty with breathing can cross a spectrum from mild to extremely severe and life-threatening. And in baby Jackson's case, he had the most severe form. Here at Lucile Packard Children's Hospital at Stanford, we have a center for maternal and fetal health. This is a group of physicians who work very, very specifically with high-risk pregnancies. We were waiting for baby Jackson to be born, and things don't always happen as expected. And 4 weeks before his expected delivery, he became unstable while still a fetus. And the experts at our Center for Maternal and Fetal Health deemed that it was critical to deliver him early, 4 weeks early. That added a whole new wrinkle to the problem and made what was probably an 8 out of 10 in terms of complexity, easily a 10 out of 10.
Right after he was born, 13 doctors came rushing in, and Andy cut the umbilical cord, I gave him a kiss, and he was gone.
Baby Jackson's surgery is an extremely complex surgical procedure, one of the most complex that we do. But it's not just about the actual surgical procedure itself. We have a team of over 100 individuals who would interact with this child both before the surgical procedure, during the procedure to support me, and after the procedure during the recovery that are absolutely critical to a successful outcome. Somewhat ironically, the part of the procedure inside the heart is the straightforward, simple part of the operation. Once that was done, we then had to move forward to the more challenging, lengthy, and delicate and complex part of the operation, which was reconstructing these very enlarged pulmonary arteries.
One of the respiratory therapists was talking to us and said that we should just watch Dr. Hanley work because he was a magician, and imagining working on a tangerine and spaghetti because that was the size of Jackson's heart.
After the 13-hour surgery, we saw Dr. Hanley in the hallway, and he told us he went from the worst case scenario to the best case scenario.
The people in the CVICU, the cardiac intensive care, really knew what they were doing. They knew what was happening. They could answer all of my questions, and I don't know if we were anywhere else, if he would have made it or we would have our son. We both knew we made the great decision to go to Stanford. At the beginning, we had a 2% chance that our son was going to survive, and now we have a 13-month-old who is trying to talk and is thriving and is making our lives amazing.